ahead and get started. Bienvenidas a todo, a todas. Before we get started with the actual lesson, I just want to go back and kind of cover some of the basics, right? For, I know, Carly, it's been, what, 2 or 3 weeks since we had our last class. And by the way, I'm pleased to introduce you to each other. We have Sky, Carly, and Leia on the class with us today. So good morning and welcome, everybody. So can everybody see my Quizlet screen here?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Yes? Okay, perfect. So remember, one of the most important aspects of learning how to speak Spanish is just learning the vocabulary, memorizing this vocabulary, okay? And according to my methodology, what I want you to do is start by looking at the side in Spanish. So we'll click down here where it says options and we'll answer with English. Okay, personas. So Sky, ¿qué significa personas?
Significa personas as person.
So it's plural, so it would be people.
People.
And for the purpose of this activity, you can just say what it means in English. Okay. Or if you want to give a complete sentence, you kind of need to say it backwards from what you just said. You would say, personas significa people. So the word significa is the verb mean, and that would go right in the middle. So we're going to start it, so we'll come back to it. Carly, ¿qué significa profesor o profesora?
Profesor, professor.
All right. Leia, estudiante.
Student.
Good. So try to remember the order that I'm calling you in so I don't have to keep repeating your name. So we're going Sky, Carly, Leia. Sky, Carly, Leia. Okay, Sky, back to you. Director o directora?
Director.
Empleado o empleada?
Ooh, no sé.
Okay, so that's going to be employee.
Employee.
Employee, yeah. And I see you're putting yourself on and off mute, Carly. For the purpose of this, we've got a really small group. Unless you have noise in the background, I would just leave your microphone on.
Okay, I have some noise in the background this morning.
Oh, you do? Okay, perfect. Okay, so we've got two terms to go back over. Personas.
People.
And empleado, empleada.
Employee.
Perfecto. All right, so we're going to switch it and go back over to answering with Spanish now. Okay, ¿cómo se dice people, Carly?
Personas.
Teacher?
Maestro, profesor.
Student?
Estudiante.
Director?
Director.
Mm-hmm. And so remember, it can be either masculine or feminine, director o directora. Employee.
Empleada.
Perfecto, right? Okay, so we've got a couple of more of these that I want to go through with you. And I'm going to share this link with you in the chat. I know, I think, Sky, you were able to join the class, but let me go ahead and put the link here in the chat if I can find it. There we go. So that you can all study with this Quizlet afterwards. Okay, next set, we've got lugares, which are places, right? All right, Sky, ¿qué significa salón de conferencia?
Conference room.
Salón de clase.
Classroom.
Oficina.
Office.
Escuela.
School.
Lugares?
Ooh, no sé.
Lugares means places.
Places.
Okay. So, Leia, lugares?
Places.
Perfecto.
Conference room.
Okay, so now we're going backwards. So, ¿cómo se dice conference room?
Salón de conferencia.
Classroom?
Salón de clase.
Office?
Oficina.
School?
Escuela.
Places.
Lugares.
Nice. We're just going to do a couple of more of these. We don't have to do every single one of them. Oops, where did it go? Lesson one. Preguntas comunes. All right, so what do these phrases mean? I think we're with Lea. ¿De dónde eres?
Where are you from?
Perfect. ¿Soy de?
I'm from.
¿Dónde vives?
Where do you live?
¿Vivo en?
I live in.
¿Dónde trabajas?
Oh, well, where do you work?
¿Trabajo en?
I work in.
Good. All right, I'd say you guys have this down pretty good. So we're gonna go ahead and jump into lección dos. Okay, lección dos. So hoy vamos a repasar las vocales y la pronunciación, los números y los saludos. And then the new stuff we're going to learn, los artículos, masculino versus femenino. So we'll learn a little of the grammar and the difference between masculine and feminine words in Spanish today. Las compras means shopping. So how to make really simple purchases in Spanish. Los colores y los adjetivos. So vocab around colors and adjectives. Y la charla trivial means small talk in Spanish, in talking about things that me gusta, I like. Vamos a practicar la pronunciación. Repiten. A.
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 E.
E.
I.
I.
O.
O.
U.
U.
A, E, I, O, U.
A, E, I, O, U.
Muy bien. So Spanish is phonetic. These vowel sounds essentially are always going to be pronounced this way. Okay, repiten. A.
A.
Nada.
Nada.
Mapa.
Mapa.
Papa.
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 Papa. Papa.
Okay, so papa. Does everybody hear the difference between papa and papa?
Mm-hmm.
Very good. So here, papa means dad, right? Here's a picture of me with my son and the crazy hair. So papa is a different word than papa. And it's because of this little accent mark that you see here. Naturally, Spanish is going to be emphasized on the second to last syllable, papa, papa, unless we see an accent mark. And that means we have to shift the emphasis of our pronunciation, papa. Now, typically speaking, when you're speaking Spanish, you know, you're just going to be kind of pronouncing things as you hear them, right? Repeating what people are saying to you. But I do want to point this out to you because it can completely change the meaning of a word from potato to dad. So if you're speaking Spanish, you don't want to call your dad a potato, right? Okay. Repiten. A.
A.
Meme.
Meme.
Leche.
Leche.
Tele.
Tele.
I.
Mini.
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 Bici.
Bici.
Fiji.
Fiji.
O.
O.
Loco.
Loco.
Coco.
Coco.
Ocho.
Ocho.
U.
U.
Cuckoo.
Cuckoo.
So notice the accent mark there. We're kind of shifting the emphasis, right? Udu.
Udu.
Guru.
Guru.
Okay, muy bien, muy bien. So guess what? If you want to start speaking Spanish, you have to start speaking Spanish. More than likely, that is going to involve introducing yourself to somebody new, right? So this is just my favorite conversation starter in the world. It works so wonderfully. And basically what you're saying is you're going to introduce yourself with your name, tell the person that you're studying Spanish, estoy estudiando español, and then you're going to ask the person to practice, podemos practicar, okay? So everybody repeat after me. Hola.
Hola.
Me llamo, in my situation, I would say me llamo David. You can say it with your names.
Me llamo Carly.
Estoy estudiando español.
Estoy estudiando español.
Podemos practicar.
Podemos practicar.
Muy bien. If you're in the right circumstance, so I have to say this, right? Because if you hear somebody speaking Spanish that's walking down the sidewalk and you start chasing them down, hey, that's practice, right? That might not work for you. But if you're in a social situation, right? Coffee shop, standing in line at the grocery store, hanging out at a party or something like that, you know, more than likely it's going to get this response, which means yes, of course. Repeat after me. Sí, por supuesto.
Sí, por supuesto.
Very good. So let's practice. Let's go Sky to Carly. So introduce yourself, Sky.
Hola, me llamo Sky. Estoy estudiando español. ¿Podemos practicar?
Sí, por supuesto.
Muy bien. Now Carly to Leah.
Hola, me llamo Carly. Estoy estudiando español. ¿Podemos practicar?
Sí, por supuesto.
And now Leah to Sky.
Hola, me llamo Lea. Estoy estudiando español. ¿Podemos practicar?
Sí, por supuesto.
Okay, nice job. So let's go through the full introduction. So I'm going to have Sky ask all 10 questions or phrases to Carly.
Hola, me llamo Sky. Estoy estudiando español. ¿Podemos practicar?
Sí, por supuesto.
¿Cómo te llamas?
Me llamo Carly.
Mucho gusto.
Igualmente.
¿De dónde eres?
Soy de Oklahoma.
¿Dónde vives?
Viven en Broomfield.
¿Dónde trabajas?
Real quick, Carly, it's going to be Bebo. Bebo. So that ending, the O ending, we're going to see this in the fourth lesson, but the O on the end literally means I. So you want to make sure to get that ending right. Bebo.
Bebo.
Perfecto.
¿Dónde trabajas?
Trabajo en Boulder.
¿Qué te gusta?
Me gusta yoga.
¿Cuál es tu número de teléfono?
Mi número de teléfono es 8-4-4-5. It's early.
Estamos en contacto.
Me parece bien. Parece?
Hasta luego.
Nos vemos.
Okay, muy bien. Ahora, Carly y Alea.
Hola, me llamo Carly. Estoy estudiando español. ¿Podemos practicar?
Sí, por supuesto.
¿Cómo te llamas?
Me llamo Lea.
Mucho gusto.
Igualmente.
¿De dónde eres?
Soy de Denver.
¿Dónde vives?
Vivo en Denver.
¿Dónde trabajas?
Trabajo en mi casa.
¿Qué te gusta?
Me gusta caminar las montañas.
¿Cuál es tu número de teléfono?
So real quick, sorry to interrupt. So this is a peculiar thing that happens between languages. They don't always translate. So we say the mountains, plural in English. In Spanish, it's typically just going to be singular. So you'd say me gusta caminar en la montaña.
La montaña.
Muy bien.
Mi número de teléfono es 303-910-5912.
Estamos en contacto.
Me parece bien.
Hasta luego.
Nos vemos.
Muy bien. And last round, Leia to Sky.
Hola. Me llamo Lea, estoy estudiando español. ¿Podemos practicar?
Sí, por supuesto.
¿Cómo te llamas?
Me llamo Sky.
Mucho gusto.
Igualmente.
¿Dónde eres?
Soy de Nebraska.
¿Dónde vives?
Vivo en Denver.
¿Dónde trabajas?
Trabajo en Frederick.
¿Qué te gusta?
Me gusta esquiar.
¿Cuál es tu número de teléfono?
Mi número de teléfono es 303-601-9901.
¿Estamos en contacto?
Me parece bien. ¿Puedes pronunciar that right?
Parece.
Parece.
Thank you.
Hasta luego.
Nos vemos.
All right, nice job. So let's continue the conversation with making small talk. And I like to use the word gustar here to talk about what we like, because everybody likes talking about that. So, Sky, ¿te gusta ir al cine?
Sí.
So you can say me gusta.
Me gusta.
Carly, ¿te gusta ir al teatro?
Sí, me gusta.
¿Te gusta ir a los conciertos?
Sí, me gusta.
¿Te gusta ir a los museos?
Sí, me gusta.
¿Te gusta escuchar música?
Sí, me gusta.
¿Te gusta escuchar radio?
Sí, me gusta.
¿Te gusta escuchar noticias?
No, no me gusta.
I don't blame you. ¿Te gusta tomar fotos?
Sí, me gusta.
¿Te gusta tomar clases de español?
Sí, me gusta.
¿Te gusta tomar café?
Sí, me gusta.
¿Te gusta tomar cerveza?
Sí, me gusta.
So somebody asked me this last week. Yes, tomar does mean to take or to drink, depending on the context. ¿Te gusta practicar esquí?
Sí, me gusta.
¿Te gusta practicar snowboarding?
Sí, me gusta.
In this one, you do say snowboarding. They have adapted to the English word. ¿Te gusta practicar deportes?
No, no me gusta.
¿Cómo se dice computer?
I can't remember. This is what, sorry, can't remember. Computadora.
Computadora. Computadora. That's why we do review. No worries. ¿Cómo se dice projector?
Proyector.
So let's start taking turns asking questions. So Sky to Carly.
Oh, sorry. ¿Cómo se dice? What am I asking her?
You could just say ¿cómo se dice? Since we have the picture, or ¿cómo se dice television with the word in English?
Okay, gotcha. Sorry. ¿Cómo se dice television?
Tele.
You can say tele. Tele is an abbreviation for televisión. The full word is televisión.
Televisión. ¿Cómo se dice oficina?
Well, you just said it. So oficina is the word.
Sorry, Leah.
That's fine.
So close.
It's like, I don't mind the help. That's okay, right? Okay, so now we'll go Leah to Sky.
¿Cómo se dice conference room?
Salón de conferencia. Oh, ¿cómo se dice classroom?
In my car.
Salón de clase.
Have a good day, okay. Muy bien. So now we're with, ¿cómo se dice director?
¿Cómo se dice director?
I answer?
Yep.
Director.
Muy bien. And now employee.
And I ask?
Sí.
¿Cómo se dice employee?
No sé. Is it empleado?
Yeah. So empleado would be for a masculine, for a male employee. Mm. For a female, we'd say empleada.
Empleada. ¿Cómo se dice? And then what is this here?
Teacher.
Teacher. ¿Cómo se dice teacher?
Maestro or profesora.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So in this situation, because it's a female teacher, you'd say maestra.
Maestra.
You got profesora, right? So that was good.
Yeah. Is this a student?
Sí.
¿Cómo se dice student?
Estudiante. ¿Cómo se dice pencil?
Un lápiz. And then when I ask, ¿cuánto cuesta?
So why don't you ask the cuánto cuesta part two, Leah? So each student just takes a slide.
Okay, so cuánto cuesta?
¿Cómo se dice cents en español?
Centavos.
Centavos. Un lápiz, 10 centavos.
Mm-hmm. So you could just say, for the purpose of this activity, I just want to practice the numbers. So if you want to, you would just say 10 centavos. If you want to give the full answer, you could just say cuesta 10 centavos. And by saying cuesta, that would include the word it. So it's like saying it costs 10 cents.
¿Cómo se dice pen?
Bolígrafo.
¿Cuánto cuesta?
$1.
Mm-hmm. And Spanish has this odd thing. So you only say uno if you're giving raw numbers, like a telephone number. The minute you use it to describe something, you cut the O off of it. So it'd just be un dólar.
Un dólar. ¿Cómo se dice book?
Libro.
¿Cuánto cuesta?
$6. ¿Cómo se dice paper?
Papel.
¿Cuánto cuesta?
$2.
Muy bien.
¿Cómo se dice marker?
Marcador.
¿Cuánto cuesta?
$3. ¿Cómo se dice whiteboard?
Sounds like pizza. That's all I can remember.
Pizarra. Pizza's even easier. It's just pizza.
Pizarra.
So, as I'll continue to talk about a lot as we move forward, the more relevant you can make your Spanish studies, the faster you're going to start speaking Spanish. So, this program that I've created is to help all of my students essentially learn what they have to learn one way or another. However, everybody has their own personal journey, right? And there are studies that say that as soon as you learn 1,000 words in any language, you can actually start speaking it, right? Because most of us use the same 1,000 words for our daily communications. Now, this of course is highly relevant to what your particular situation is, right? So my 1,000 words as a teacher, you know, I'm frequently talking about teaching homework students, right? Which probably the only time you ever use words like that is when you come to Spanish class. So you still have to learn them, right? But depending on what you do for work, that can change a great deal the vocabulary that you're using. So I do want to open you up to this idea and give you a chance. If anybody would like to ask me some custom vocabulary, I like talking about things at work. Of course, we're now working and living at home. So if you want to ask me things about your house, you can do that too. Would anybody like to ask me some questions here with ¿Cómo se dice?
Actually, it's not a ¿Cómo se dice? I have actually a question that I've actually asked other Spanish speakers this. So I listened to that radio station. It's Tricolor 96.5.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And they I think it might be a slang term because they use the word chocolate, but they use it in all of their advertisements. And I was wondering if it meant like smooth or suave or something like that, or if there was some kind of slang translation for chocolate besides the food.
Chocolate is chocolate. I don't know how I would have to hear
the context.
The more context there, yeah. But
that's exactly what the other Spanish speaker told me. So it's been like a mystery that's been bothering me.
I personally have not heard chocolate in any slang type use. Other than to perhaps like be used as a term of endearment for somebody, right? Like if you're dating a person of color, you know, you might call them like your bombón de chocolate, right? But
okay.
You know, like your sweet chocolate, but I, that's the only possible thing that I can perhaps think of.
Well, maybe once I learn more Spanish, I'll understand the context more and I'll understand.
Yeah, I would imagine they're advertising some type of chocolate product, though, if that's what you're hearing an ad for.
It's in their station announcement, so I don't know. We'll see. If I ever figure it out, I'll let you know.
Maybe they have a radio host that's part of their name, his or her name. I don't. I really don't know. I can't think of.
Proper noun. Yeah, I never thought of that. That's a good.
You know, I'll listen to Tricolor every now and then when I'm kind of scanning through radio stations or something. That's a very famous radio station. I'm surprised.
Oh, it's great. I love it.
Say that. Yeah. Tricolor, if anybody wants to. So I can tell you an interesting thing. The Tricolor is referring to the three colors of the Mexican flag. Three colors. So it's representing the green, white, and red. So that's kind of what that whole station is referring to.
Awesome. Thank you.
So there's that kind of brings up a good topic though. So not to say that that's not a good activity, right? Because I think it, at the end of the day, anything you can do to listen to Spanish is going to be good for you in the long run. However, depending on your level, like I would not necessarily recommend listening to Spanish radio just yet, because if you don't have the context and if you can't exactly see what the words are, like if you don't know exactly what you're listening to, it's not necessarily helping you, if that makes sense. I do like for this very beginning level to listen to music. In our next class, we'll have a little listening activity for music where you can listen to a song and look up the lyrics on Google online, you know, and kind of follow along with the lyrics and then isolate words and stuff like that. But this is like a classic example, right? You're hearing chocolate, but you don't understand the full context. And so it's kind of leaving you with more questions than it is answers, if that makes sense. But keep doing it. You know, it's not a bad thing. It's just not necessarily the most productive thing at this particular level. Maybe.
Can I ask a quick question? Maybe you can answer it, you know, send us a text or something. Are there any podcasts, like when I'm walking my dog, I could listen to a beginner's Spanish podcast?
Yeah, there are podcasts. Again, not 100% the best use of your time. Like I would rather you get into like find a few songs that you like and learn the lyrics to it and kind of listen to that. That's going to be better for you. But to answer your question, where's my phone? Here it is. I got to look this up because I just came across it. I saved it a long time ago. El Hilo. Okay. I can send you an email after this. So there's one called El Hilo that's supposed to be pretty good for Spanish. Duolingo has podcasts. So that's another one for you. But I think my favorite one is something called Spanish con Salsa. And it's a whole podcast that's dedicated towards teaching Spanish based off of salsa songs. Mm-hmm. So that would probably be my favorite one for you to listen to. Bien. Any como se dice questions? So you don't, if you can't think of anything right off the bat, after class, just look around, right? Look around your room. We've all got a wall, right? So if you don't know how to say wall, look it up. If you're at a desk and you don't know how to say desk, look it up and start kind of incorporating Spanish into your daily life. And for bonus points, write this stuff down on little sticky notes. And then label the stuff in your office, in your home office or your, you know, work office. So that way, just when you're, you know, you get into work, you look down, you see Spanish, right? And that's going to incorporate it into your daily life. And the faster you learn how to say everything in your surroundings, like the more comfortable that you'll be, because there's always going to be this like unspoken level of anxiety if you don't know how to say stuff, right? So, muy bien. Masculine and feminine. So this is one of the biggest differences between Spanish and English, that everything is either going to be considered a masculine word or a feminine word in Spanish. We'll talk about people first, because this applies in English as well. Most words in Spanish either end with an O or an A. The words that end with O are typically masculine words, like niño means boy. And then words that end with A are typically feminine words, like niña, which ends with A, right? Ojo, here's a little Spanish nonverbal communication for you. Ojo is like saying, keep your eyes open, or in other words, be careful. This rule has exceptions to it. So sometimes we will see words that end with O that are feminine and vice versa, but they're few and far between. So articles are words that combine with nouns to help us define exactly what we're talking about. They're just like little helper words. They change based off of the gender of the noun. So the masculine word for the or the is going to be el, and feminine is la. So if I wanted to say the boy, I would say el niño. And if I wanted to say the girl, I'd say la niña. El profesor, la profesora. So that means, as we've seen in the past, teacher, right? Based off of their gender. So this ends with an R. Not all words end with O or A. So what happens if we come across one of those? Typically speaking, words that are going to end with a consonant, especially the R or the N, are going to be masculine words, and we can add an A to it to turn it into the feminine version of that word. So patrón means boss, el patrón or la patrona. And then we do have like gender neutral words or unisex words. Typically they end with E, like estudiante, right? Notice, however, the article will change. El estudiante, la estudiante, depending on the gender of the person we're describing. In the plural form, we change el to los and la to las. So we get el niño. And to make that the boys, we change it to los niños. So changing el to los, and then also adding an S to nouns that end with a vowel. If it ends with, la niña, las niñas. So there's just your feminine version. If it ends with a consonant, we add ES in an extra syllable. La mujer means the woman. Las mujeres means the women. Okay. Now we've got los niños, meaning the boys, together with las niñas, meaning the girls. Collectively, we're going to use the masculine word to refer to a mixed gender group, los niños. So same thing here, like el padre is the father, la madre is the mother. When we combine them, we're going to refer to our parents as los padres. So just a quick recap. Articles are going to match the nouns in both number and gender. El niño, los niños, la niña, las niñas. Let's practice with this a little bit. So let's start with you, Sky. How would you say the brother?
El hermano.
And then same, so each student takes a slide. So Sky, the brothers.
Los hermanos.
Carly?
La hermana, las hermanas.
Muy bien. Lea. So now we've got siblings together.
Los hermanos.
Perfecto. Muy bien. Sky?
La madre and los padres.
Okay, so this looks like it's actually a group of all mothers.
Oh, sorry. So that would be, what's the article? Las madres.
There you go.
El padre, los padres.
Now we've got parents together, Leia.
Los padres.
La alumna and el alumno.
Muy bien.
Los niños.
So we're looking for, so if back here we have alumno,
mm-hmm.
over here we've got, we're still going with alumno, just the plural version of it.
So los alumnos.
Muy bien.
And then same thing here.
Yeah, so it's a mixed gender group.
So still los alumnos.
Ahí está, perfecto. Okay, Leo.
La maestra, el maestro.
Muy bien.
What is this a group of?
Teachers.
Oh, teachers. los maestros and las maestras. Is
muy that bien. Right? Sí. Absolutamente. Muy bien.
El estudiante, las, la estudiante.
Los estudiantes, las estudiantes, estudiantes.
So, yeah, this one, so estudiante doesn't change, so you're just adding an S.
Las estudiantes, okay.
El hombre, la mujer.
Los hombres, las mujeres.
Muy bien.
El profesor, la profesora.
Are those professors again?
Yep.
Okay, so los profesores and profesores and las profesores.
And so remember, profesor changes to profesora. So in the plural version, we just add an S to that. Las profesoras.
Okay.
El hijo, la hija.
Los hijos.
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 Muy bien. Muy bien. So now for the fun stuff. This rule applies to things as well. So el libro, ending with O, is an indication that the book is a boy. Why is the book a boy? We don't know. It just is, right? La mesa is a girl. The table is a girl. The real reason is that Latin worked this way. So naturally, all the Romance languages that are born from Latin work this way. But there's nothing like, there's no logic you can apply to this. I have students all the time that are like, well, that doesn't sound like a masculine word. Yeah, you'll drive yourself crazy if you're trying to apply logic. It's just best to learn the words as they are, because there's no reason for this. El marcador is the marker, los marcadores, the markers, plural, because it ends with an R, we add ES to it. And then just because we've learned the word el lápiz for pencil, spelling wise, we have a little change here, right? We change lápiz to los lápices, changing the Z to a C and then adding ES. So this is the rule that applies to words that end with Z. Not a whole lot of them, right? But there's a few of them. Leah, remember for learning like the European Spanish, you pronounce the Z or the C like a th, like you have a lisp, right?
Lápiz.
Perfecto. So Carly and Sky, more than likely you're not going to need to learn the European Spanish pronunciation. Leah is actually has a really great story. What's it? Your son is marrying.
My son is marrying a woman from Madrid.
Oh, awesome.
So she's learning Spanish to be able to speak with the new in-laws, right?
Yeah. Teresa speaks English, but her parents don't. So, and I'm meeting them at Christmas.
Oh, how fun.
Okay, so el libro, los libros, la planta, la plantas, las plantas. Again, we see singular, plural, masculine, and feminine. So let's practice with this. Sky, lápiz.
El lápiz. And los lápices.
Muy bien. Carly?
El papel. Los papeles. Papel, Okay.
You got it. Yeah, los papeles.
El libro, los libros.
El bolígrafo and los bolígrafos.
La mesa, las mesas.
La pizarra, las pizarras.
El clase, los clase.
You'd be right to guess masculine. Unfortunately, this is a feminine word, la clase.
La clase and las clases.
Muy bien.
La planta, las plantas.
La silla, las sillas.
El marcador, los marcadores.
El teléfono, los teléfonos. ¿Teléfonos?
Mm-hmm. Muy bien.
El caramelo, los caramelos.
La mochila, las mochilas.
Muy bien.
El escritorio, los escritorios.
Okay, so let's learn a little dialogue to go shopping. So we can have Carly, how about you be the person on the left, and then Leia, you can be the person on the right here.
Okay.
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
Estoy bien, gracias. ¿Cuánto cuesta el lápiz?
El lápiz cuesta 10 centavos.
Bien, ¿cuánto cuesta el papel?
El papel cuesta $1.
Llevo el papel y el lápiz.
Gracias. Chao.
Nos vemos.
Muy bien. So basically, we're just starting off with our regular greetings. How much does the pencil cost, given the price there? That's straightforward. We're just asking about paper now. At the end, this is important. Llevo el papel y el lápiz. This is like saying I'll take it when I say llevo. I'll take the paper and the pencil. Okay, so let's practice here. So Leia, you can be the salesperson here. And Sky, tú necesitas comprar. You need to buy the pencil and the book, el lápiz y el libro.
Okay.
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
Estoy bien, gracias. ¿Cuánto cuesta el lápiz y el libro?
So just start with one at a time. ¿Cuánto cuesta el lápiz?
¿Cuánto cuesta el lápiz?
Lápiz cuesta 10 centavos.
Bien, ¿cuánto cuesta el libro?
El libro cuesta 9 dólares.
Llevo lápiz y el libro.
Gracias. Chao.
Nos vemos.
Muy bien. Okay, so Sky, you're selling. Carly, you're buying.
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
Estoy bien, gracias. ¿Cuánto cuesta? ¿Cómo se dice pen en español?
El bolígrafo.
Bolígrafo. ¿Cuánto cuesta el bolígrafo?
Bolígrafo cuesta $1.
And make sure to say the article there. El bolígrafo.
El bolígrafo.
El bien. Bolígrafo cuesta $1.
Bien, ¿cuánto cuesta el papel? El papel.
El papel cuesta $2.
Llevo y la bolígrafa y el papel.
Gracias. Chao.
Nos vemos.
What does chao mean? Is that the same as Italian, like C-A-I-O?
Essentially, yeah, it's just another way of saying bye. Now, in Italian, I think you use ciao. Leia's our resident Italian expert. In Italy, ciao is both hello and goodbye, right?
Correct. But it's more usually goodbye, but that's how it started, but you say it anytime.
Okay. In Spanish, it's only to say goodbye. So chao. All right. Next round. Who's selling? Is it Carly selling now?
Yeah, I think it's me selling.
Leia buying.
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
Estoy bien, gracias. ¿Cuánto cuesta el marcador?
El marcador cuesta $3.
Bien, ¿cuánto cuesta la pizarra?
La pizarra cuesta $10.
Llevo el marcador y la pizarra.
Gracias, chao.
Nos vemos.
Okay, nice job. I means there is or there are. For example, looking at the picture here, I could say hay tres lápices, right? If I wanted to specify that there's one blue pencil, I could say hay un lápiz azul. So let's practice here. Take turns asking each other these questions here. So Carly, ask Leia and choose whichever image you want to describe, you want to ask about.
So, ¿cuántos los marcadores hay?
Yeah, so here, don't say the article, just say ¿cuántos marcadores hay? How many markers are there?
¿Cuántos marcadores hay?
Hay cuatro marcadores.
Do I ask all of them?
And now Leia to Sky, just keep going around the circle.
¿Cuántos I could never say that word. Biografo.
Bolígrafos.
Bolígrafo. ¿Cuántos bolígrafos hay?
Hay ocho bolígrafos. Oh, and then I got, ¿cuántos libros hay?
Hay seis libros. Let's see. ¿Cómo se dice? Is it, would it be colored pencil in that case? In
the just
case?
Pencils, yeah. ¿Cuántos lápices?
Oh, okay. Okay. ¿Cuántos lápices hay?
Hay 10 lápices. ¿Cuántos teléfonos hay?
Hay 9 teléfonos. ¿Cuántas pizarra hay?
Hay un pizarra.
So this one, because it's feminine, of course, now we're going to say una. Hay una pizarra.
Una pizarra. ¿Cómo se dice plants?
Plantas.
Plantas. ¿Cuántas plantas hay?
Hay 5 plantas. ¿Cuántas maestra hay?
Hay un maestra.
So here you'll say una maestra.
Hay una maestra. ¿Cuántas estudiantes hay?
Hay 4 estudiantes.
Repiten, 11.
11.
12.
12.
13?
13.
14?
14.
15.
15.
So study these independently. They kind of follow an irregular pattern. Okay, the rolling R's. You probably already have heard the rolling R's in Spanish. The R sound gets exaggerated. So there's an expression in Spanish to talk about delicious food. You say que rico, right? And that's like saying how delicious. It sounds like how rich, right? Like we can imagine eating a really rich piece of chocolate. However, in Spanish, it's really more used for delicious as opposed to the way we use it to describe rich food, right? So rico should be exaggerated at the beginning, right? Most English speakers learning Spanish will say rico, which is fine. You'll more than likely be understood because of the context, but it would be good for you to try to get the rolling R down. So how do you do it? Most of us as small children pretended to be a cat or a tiger and growl or a motorboat or like make a motor sound like playing cars, you know? So it's kind of this vibration that starts in your throat and pushes up through your tongue. So it's not actually something like that you concentrate on the tip of your tongue with. It's more of an internal sound that gets pushed up and out. If you want to do this, I can just about guarantee you that you can do it. If you just think positive and you keep trying at it, right? Most of my students that try it, get it. I have students that are just like, forget about that. I'm never going to be able to do it. That's fine. There is some physiology here. The human face has over 50 muscles in it. And this includes muscles all over your face and your tongue and, you know, all this whole area. And this is growing and being formed up until about the time that we are 16 years old. So accents are formed by the time that you're 16. You will more than likely speak Spanish with an American accent, right? Or a French accent for some of us. But the point is perfecting an accent, in my opinion, shouldn't be the goal, right? If you get really hung up on speaking Spanish perfectly, you miss the point of learning how to communicate, right? Mm-hmm. And if you've ever talked to somebody from the southeast part of the United States, you know that people from Georgia or Florida or North Carolina have an accent, right? And it's very distinguishable. When you talk to them right off the bat, you're like, this person is not from Colorado. Mm-hmm. But can you talk to them? Of course, right? So that's kind of my opinion on this. I still think that physiologically, it may be hard to get the rolling R for some of us, right? I never like to say it's impossible. For some people, it might be impossible just because I work with adults that are learning how to speak this way past the age of 16. So that sound might be hard to be reproduced, but keep trying. For the purpose of today, I want you to know exactly when you should roll the R, because it doesn't always get rolled. For instance, if it's a singular R in the middle of a word or at the end of a word, it's a very subtle sound. It almost sounds like a D as opposed to an R, right? So try to listen when I say these words. Pero, pera, caro, cero. Do you hear how subtle that is? Like it's almost hard to even say, oh, that's an R, right? It gets rolled if there are two R's in the middle of a word. So now notice the difference between pero and perro. Can you hear the difference?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now we've got perra, carro, cerro. In my opinion, you know, it is important to try and get this because those are different words. Pero means but. It's the conjunction word but. Perro is a dog. Pera is the fruit, the pear. Perra is a female dog. Caro means expensive. Carro means car. And so then you can have un carro caro, which would be an expensive car. And then cerro means zero, and cerro means a hill, like at the foothills of the mountain, right? So it's important to try and get those. However, you know, again, not to get too hung up on perfect pronunciation, because of the context of a conversation, if you're not rolling the R's, you should still be understood because of the context of the conversation. Another circumstance where it rolls, if it's a singular R, but it's the very first letter of a word. So everybody try to repeat after me. Rancho.
Rancho.
Recibir.
Recibir.
Rio.
Rio.
Rojo.
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 Ruso.
Ruso.
Perfecto. Bien. Any questions about that?
So an R at the beginning of a word always rolls, or only in certain circumstances?
At the beginning of the word, it should always roll.
Okay.
Bien. ¿Cuál es tu nombre? That means, what is your name? Okay, it's just another way we learned in the past, ¿cómo te llamas? Another way would be to say, ¿cuál es tu nombre? So let's practice here. So Sky to Carly.
¿Cuál es tu nombre?
Mi nombre es Carly.
Carly to Lea.
¿Cuál es tu nombre?
Mi nombre es Lea. ¿Cuál es tu nombre?
Mi nombre es Sky.
Perfecto. So also pay attention here to our possessive adjectives. To say my, you say me. To say your, you say tú. Muy bien. So let's learn our colors before we wrap things up because it's 9 o'clock. Repiten, rosado. Sorry, it's 8 o'clock. Rosado.
Rosado.
Gris.
Gris.
Negro.
Negro.
Azul.
Azul.
Verde.
Verde.
Amarillo.
Amarillo.
Anaranjado.
Anaranjado.
Rojo.
Rojo.
Morado.
Morado.
Marrón.
Marrón.
Blanco.
Blanco.
Okay. Nice job, everybody.